fellas. Are you sad? Lonely? Convinced there's not a single woman on earth who could possibly love you? Well, I'm here to tell you you're probably right. But that doesn't mean you have to be alone forever. Because if no one on the planet will have you, then why not look off the planet? That's right. As we speak, there are somewhere between zero and infinity beautiful alien girls drifting through the cosmos. And if you act now, one of them could drift straight into your waiting arms. The universe is a place of infinite possibilities, and thus, statistically speaking, there has to be at least one person out there who can tolerate you. Perhaps the love of your life is waiting for you on Sarin, a planet with a 90% female population where men are a hot commodity. Literally, if rumors of the planet's black market are to be believed. In light of this, the Space Patrol has placed a strict travel advisory against men visiting Sarin, but there's nothing to stop these eager young ladies from coming to you. At least not once you've sponsored their permit to leave the planet and agreed to take responsibility for any abductions that result from their release. But that's just one planet out of a countless number in this vast universe. Out there, you'll find worlds beyond your wildest imagination, populated by alien beauties of all kinds. There are planets full of Oni girls, demon girls, even cat girls. Why, if modern science didn't tell us otherwise, we'd almost think the genetic makeup of the galaxy had been dictated by the whims of a horny 20-something comic artist. This isn't just a matter of appearances, though. These women come from vastly different cultures, with different values and norms, where maybe you're not such a loser. Why, there could be planets out there where women gauge the virility of potential mates by the size of their figurine collections and their willingness to wear Ahegao t-shirts. Or worlds where Constank has a powerful aphrodisiac effect. Anything is possible. We don't actually research these planets enough to know for sure, but our market research has told us that, statistically, you're desperate enough to give us your money anyway. And you're not alone. Well, you are, obviously, but you know what I mean. Plenty of Earth men have already met their space soulmates and are currently living with their alien bride, or brides. If you've found yourself with three or more alien mates, please consult the Harem Survival Guide for further advice. Just listen to this testimony from a satisfied customer.
I can't get away from her! Help me, please!
So what are you waiting for? Contact the SpaceX Corporation, our lawyers are insisting I clarify that that is SpaceX with an S-E, to find yourself a wife who is truly out of this world today. What else are you gonna do? Improve yourself?
The SpaceX Corporation makes no guarantees that your space bride is capable of digesting Earth food. The SpaceX Corporation is not liable for any damages caused by your space bride or any intergalactic armies that may or may not be pursuing her. It is up to you to pay for the removal of any eggs that your space bride lays in your abdomen. Though if eggs are implanted in your brain, you are entitled to compensation up to 5,000 credits. In the event that your space bride turns out to be a space pirate evading the authorities, it is your responsibility to contact the Space Patrol. Failure to do so may result in fines, imprisonment, or the planet Earth being conquered by alien invaders. Calls to SpaceX, Mark Alec.
Hey, basement dwellers, you may have noticed this is a bit different from my usual PSAs, and that's because it was made as part of the AnnieTuber anthology over on Under the Scope, which is a big collaborative project featuring a ton of cool creators, including Glass Reflection, Baron J, Replay Value, Bonsai Pop, Pedantic Romantic, and Mr. Nice Guy, who you may recognize as one of my regular editors, among others. The theme of this anthology was space, and for my contribution, I wanted to poke fun at a harem anime trope that I think has some very sad implications. I wasn't originally intending to put this out as its own video, since, as you can see, it's pretty short. My plan for today was actually to put out what's in an OP Neon Genesis Evangelion, but a bunch of problems have come up over the last couple days that made it impossible to put that out before Tuesday. So, in lieu of that, I hope you enjoyed this shorter, even more shitposty take on the PSA format. If it does well and you guys actually do like it, who knows, maybe I'll do more short comedy videos like this one in the future. At any rate, now that you're done here, please go check the rest of the anthology out at the link in the doobly-doo or on screen. And of course, stay tuned for that Ava OP analysis. It's going to be worth the wait, I promise. I'm Jeff Thu, professional shitbag, signing out from my mother's basement.